Howdy, this is Mackenzie Franklin from SideGame LLC here in Colorado Springs, Colorado. Today we're going to be taking a look at Role Player by Thunderworks Games and checking out at how to organize it. Now this is going to be the deluxe box with all current expansion and promo content available for the game with no lid lift. Now that being said, let's go ahead and jump in. Now in addition to no lid lift, there's going to be also all sleeved cards. Let's see what happens. So first off, we have all of the rule books for the different games. So base game, monsters and minions, as well as the Fiends and Familiars expansion. All of these are perfectly fine to leave on top. That way they stay nice and flat. You also have a role player monsters and minions sheet here. This is a laminated version. That way you can transfer your characters over from this game to the new role player adventures. You can also print out multiple copies of these if you need them. Generally, we would write on here if you really want to save one, snap a picture and call it a day, or if you can print them out if you'd like as well. Next, we have two distinct sections. On this right section, we're going to have all the cards and some of the tokens, and the left section, we're going to have all the dice and some of the tokens. So let's go ahead and look at the left section first. So first off, we have the giant dice bag, and this is going to contain all of your dice from all the different expansions. So that's going to include your basic dice, your split dice, as well as your boost dice. I love these, so fun. So that's all on the left side. Next, we're just going to use a simple box here. This is actually from a cosmetic product, but it works really nicely. You can use any type of container or a bag, just like this one, because I like having open containers when everything else is kind of storing on top. Those rule books on top are going to keep any of the dice from escaping. So I really like this open container. It's got all of your combat dice in it. Next, we have some dollar store containers. These are 10 for a dollar. You can get the round or you can get the square. I like a mixture of both, kind of differentiates what's in what. For example, these square tokens here are going to be in the square box, like that. In addition, you'll have all of your charisma tokens, as well as the player tokens in this one, since you'll need those every game. And then in this round one here, you're going to have your metal coins for the threes. You'll have all your location, object, and area, or sorry, attack tokens. So these are for the Monsters and Minions expansion. And then lastly, you're going to have those ones for your money as well. So it's all going to fit nicely into those sections here. In addition, on this left side, you're going to have all of your familiars. So these are from that Familiar and Fiends expansion. You're just going to put them on the left side. That way you can shuffle them up randomly and give them to each player. On the right side here, we are actually using a box from the Arkham Horror card game. So I do not store those in these boxes, but these are really nice, just very long boxes. You definitely don't need something this long. You can use any form of cardboard. Once again, it's got that open face, so it's easy to just grab stuff out of it. But things are organized very nicely here. On this right side here, we have all of your monsters. I really like the 3D monsters. We had ours when we arrived. They were warped. All you needed to do was simply bend them to one side and they stayed. So very nice here. I will leave links in the description for all of the different sleeves and sizes that I use for this game. So these are all of your monsters as well as your player reference cards and score markers. So they all fit nicely there on that right side in that empty section. We also have your first player marker. You have your two containers here that are going to contain your damage, your wound markers, as well as your XP tokens. This is all going to fit nicely there. And then in here, we're going to have all of these small and large cards. And I don't think I really need to take these out. You're just going to organize them by type. So you have all the different monster attacks. You have your different location objective attacks. You have your all your alignment cards. So these are all going to fit nicely here, but you definitely want to separate so that these experience cards are in an accessible place. Those will all go on this right side. On this left side, you have all your large cards. So that includes your minions. They all fit nicely there. And then your market cards as well. You are going to want to separate them by the little number or the low number of dots here in the corner. So this is one dot, so it's a level one card. So separate them into the level one and two cards, because the game is going to have you start with the level ones and then progress into level twos. You're also going to have all of your backstory cards, as well as your initiative cards and your class cards. So you have lots of different things that you'll be taking a look at. And most importantly, make sure you keep this separate. This is the Call to Adventure card. You're going to use this if you're playing with the Fiends and Familiar expansion. These are all going to go here in this section. So very nice, super easy. Basically, big cards then small cards. Once again, not going to get into too much detail. Just separate them by the appropriate type. And then use these containers to keep them nice and firm so that nothing is going to slide around or move out. And then you also have a silica gel pack in here for freshness. And they'll put those large tarot cards on the right side here to just ensure that nothing is going to be moving around. And that's really nice because it fits in here perfectly. Once again, these are the Arkham Horror boxes. You can also use things like the Magic Fat Pet boxes or the Pokemon boxes, shoe boxes, anything that has this dimension, anything that's just going to keep it open. So I really like these. You simply pull it out, put it on the table, it's ready to go. And underneath that box, we're going to have all of your player characters. So these are just all pretty much the same. So you can just pick the one that you think sounds fun. There's only a slight variation on these with the +2 and -2 to specific stats. Some characters, like the human, though, has no changes. So just based on which character that you think is fun. And a nice touch I like about this is they are double-sided. So you can have one side be the male and one side be the female version of the same character. So I really like that touch, and I think it works extremely well. With that being said, let's go ahead and pack it up. So first off, let's go ahead and put all of those player boards, and then we'll place the large box of cards. Then we're going to take all of the familiars and put them on the left side. We'll take all of our square containers and put them like so. Put our dice container here, and then put all of these round containers. So one flat, and then two on their sides like so. We'll take our dice and kind of drape them into this left side, so that way they're lying under the section that's, you know, kind of sectioned off by this box in the middle here. And then we'll drape the rule books on top here, like so. And that is organizing role player. If you have any questions about what you saw here, please let me know down in the comments below. How do you organize your copy of role player? What organizers do you use? I'd love to hear your thoughts. Thank you so much for watching Side Game Strong.